Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 23 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now, in the previous video, I introduced you to the 3D viewports and the outliner, and I showed you how you can make subtitles for your movie by creating multiple text objects in the 3D viewport, importing the 3D viewport scene into your sequencer, and changing the visibility of each of those text objects as we go forward in time. Now in today's video, I'm going to show you another way that we can create subtitles in Blender, and I believe that this method is actually faster to set up, and it definitely renders faster. So what I've done is I've created a subtitling template, and you guys can go into the description below, and I will provide a link to the latest version of the Mikey Cal subtitling template. Okay, I brought up the subtitling template. Let me show you guys how it works. Now, over here is the 3D viewport. It might not look like 3D viewport because I've removed the grid from the background, and I've locked everything in place so you can't really move anything by clicking accidentally. And what I have is I've made 40 different text objects that you can alter, and each text object is only visible for one frame of the sequence. So if you hit your right arrow key on your keyboard, it will take you to the next text object. You can keep hitting the right arrow key and see all of the text objects. Now, if you go all the way back to the beginning and go to the first frame, you'll notice that instead of text, we actually have a background. Now, this is an optional background that you can use if you're having a hard time seeing your text in your subtitles because of the coloring of your movie. So all you need to do to get started is go to the second frame of the sequencer and right click on the first text item and hit tab and type in whatever you want to say and hit tab to return to object view. Then all you have to do is hit your right arrow key and that takes you to the next item. Right click on that item, tab, and type in additional text. And tab to go back to the object mode. Now you can go down and do as many of these as you like. Then when you're finished, put your mouse cursor over the timeline and hit your E button. And what that does is it sets the ending frame range to end at the last edited text object. So you don't have to render out all 40 objects. Like in this case, we're going to only render frame 1 through 3. So if you want to make changes to the color of the text object, you can do that by going over to diffuse here and you can change the color. And all of these objects are linked to the exact same material. So if I change it for this object, it will also change it for the other objects. And over here we have all the settings for fonts and stuff like that. If you want to actually add a specific font, you can click on this folder right here and you can select any font that you like and it will change that font. Now, the problem with changing the fonts is that they're not all linked together, so you actually would have to go through each of the text items and just set the font for that. But the colors can be changed relatively quickly just by switching them right here. Now, we've set our color. Actually, let's set it back to white. And let's go and animate this out. So I'm going to hit the animation button, and you can see it's generating each of these transparent PNG files, and it's finished. Now what we're going to do is we're going to open up our movie project that we want to add the subtitles to, and we're going to go back to the first frame of the video, and we're going to go down to this little add menu, and we're going to add image, and by default, the images will be saved in the same folder that that Blender template is located in. I'm going to highlight over the images that it generated and add image strip. Now you can't see it because the strip is so small, so let's actually hit our Shift and B button to get this little crosshair. This is the box zoom or the border zoom. Highlight over with your left mouse button and zoom in, and you can see that we actually have a little strip here. Make sure that it's selected by right-clicking on it. and go over to the blend setting, and we want to set it to alpha over, and now you can see through it. Now, here is a feature that is something that's nice to know. If you go to the strip menu, you can select this option called separate images, or you can press the Y button. And when you do that, it asks you how long do you want each image to last? What duration of frames? Now, a 24 frame per second video is going to, that's going to mean that every 24 frames is equal to 1 second. So we can actually just have Blender do the math for us. Let's say that I want them to be 5 seconds long. I can type in 24 times 5, hit enter, and it tells me it's 120. So it actually made each of these images into separate image strips that are 120 frames long. So this first strip here is our optional background strip. So what I would recommend you do is zoom out by using your mouse wheel, scrolling down. We're going to actually select the text image strips, hit G and Y to constrain it on the Y axis and go up one. And we're just going to take this background strip right here and we're going to make it match the length of the video. I'm going to hit my home key so I can see everything. So we know this video is 10,720. So I'm just going to right click on that first strip and set the length to 10,720. Hit enter and it made it go the full way. No matter where I am in this video, you now have this little background black bar. And we're going to take our text strips and we're going to move them to the location we want them to be. I'm going to start this one at the first frame. And let's shift B to zoom in a little bit here so we can get closer. And now you can see the text is there. And if we want to actually make it longer, we can actually grab this little handle and we can with our right mouse button and drop it. And it will go longer. And you can add as many of these subtitles as you want. I'd recommend that when you're actually typing in all the subtitles that you type them all in order. That way you don't have to rearrange everything. You just have to maybe make some adjustments to place them to cover a certain number of frames. So that's how the subtitling template works. Let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you in the next video.